By the end of this video, you will know what linear voltage regulators are, how they work, some very hot limitations, and why you should keep them around. Whenever we are building an electronic circuit, there is one very important thing that we need to make sure there is. And of course, I'm talking about a power source. Since if we didn't have any power to begin with, our circuit would, well, do nothing at all. But this also brings up an issue that we may face: how to make sure our circuit has a clean and reliable power source. Another issue is that our circuit will be calculated to run at a certain voltage, say 5 volts, for example. But what if the power brick we plug into the wall provides 12 volts? We need some way to take a higher voltage level and lower it for use in our circuit. Thankfully, since this is a common thing to do, there is an electrical component called a linear voltage regulator that does just that. If we take a look at one, we will see that there are 3 pins. All we need to do is hook up the input to the voltage source, the common pin to ground, and the output pin to our circuit. But wait a second. If we did this, we might be welcomed with a very unpleasant surprise in the form of our voltage regulator burning up. You may be asking yourself, why would someone make an electrical component that could burn up just for doing what it was designed to do in the first place? This has to do with conservation of energy. We can calculate the amount of energy that our circuit is using by multiplying the current and the voltage together. For instance, if we had a 5-volt circuit drawing 2 amps of current, we would be using 10 watts. But now say we wanted to make ourselves a phone charger from a 12-volt power supply in our car. We now know that the current going through the circuit will not change, and on one side of the regulator we have 12 volts and 2 amps. On the other side is 5 volts and 2 amps. If we calculate the power on each side of the regulator, we can see we're feeding 24 watts into the linear regulator and are only getting 10 out the other end. And this is because the linear voltage regulator is taking all that extra energy and is converting it into heat. This means that the regulator will be responsible for dissipating the power difference, which is 14 watts. I will leave a link in the description below that will take you to an interactive calculator on my website to help you out. This brings us to the first main limitation of linear voltage regulators, which is that they're not very energy efficient. Because of this, you will only reach for this type of regulator if you are dealing with low power embedded circuits. But still, these components are used in many electronic devices, although you will see that they generally are accompanied by a large heat sink or the PCB has been designed to dissipate the heat. If you were to look at the schematic of the Arduino development board, you would see that it uses a linear voltage regulators for its power needs. Now let's look at how we can use a linear voltage regulator in our circuit. First, we need to know what our desired output voltage and current are. Let's stick with 5 volts and 2 amps for this example. Next, we need to know what our input voltage is. We also need to make sure that the input voltage is higher than the output voltage, or else our linear voltage regulator won't work. If you need to increase the voltage, you will need to grab yourself a boost converter. There are 2 types of linear voltage regulators: fixed voltage and variable voltage. With a fixed voltage linear regulator, it comes preset with a certain voltage. For example, some common part numbers are L7805 for a 5-volt regulator and an L7809 for a 9-volt regulator. While these are great if we have a standard voltage, there will be times when you need an odd voltage or to change the voltage dynamically. For these applications, we can use a variable linear regulator, which uses resistors to give feedback to the regulator in order to set the desired output voltage. The datasheet will provide the various calculations depending on your circuit setup. As with most integrated circuits that we use in our own circuit designs, we need to keep in mind that most of them recommend or even require that certain capacitors to be used in order to keep the power supply reliable. These values can also be found in the datasheet. I always keep a kit of assorted linear voltage regulators on my electronics bench since I always find myself reaching for them. If you want to get some for yourself, I will link a link in the description below. If you found this video useful, feel free to give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to support the channel. And I will see you next time.